Hallelujah. When we conquer the world of business and commerce, the tithe will be enough in this church.
Hallelujah.
And I'm prophesying increase in tithe giving in this church in the name of Jesus. I say it again, I prophesy. And I always tell people, a million is just a one with the six zeros only. The Reverend's church. One, then zero, zero, zita, akeake. Who says you can't do it? God is looking for men and women who can get position so that they will receive the wealth of the wicked. And some people are here, and I see them here in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Tell yourself, I'm one of them. It is time for the church to confront Satan out there. Out there in the world. Bishop, I was sent something that I said I wanted to read here tonight by my friend in the UK. Says that the church in the UK is like it's dying. And the people to go and revive the church or the kingdom of God are here. Because Kenya has been prophesied as a springboard of revival even before I got born again. Kenya is a springboard of revival. Where missionaries came and preached to us, churches are closing down. And Muslims are taking over. UK alone, the mayor of London is a Muslim. The mayor of Birmingham is a Muslim. The mayor of Leeds is a Muslim. The mayor of Blackburn is a Muslim. The mayor of Sheffield, Muslim. Oxford, Luton, Oldham, Rockdale. The guys I see it. There are over 3,000 mosques. 130 Sharia courts. Over 50 Muslim Sharia councils. There are some areas that are designated Muslim only go zone. No other person. If you are not a Muslim, you can't go there. We don't want to see that ever happen to our country. When we are alive and we are going to impart to the next generation so that they will never ever drop a baton. Hallelujah. They say that 78% of Muslim women, they don't work. And they receive money for housing and free benefits. Are you listening to what I'm saying? 63% of Muslim men will never work. And yet they receive benefits. And who pay the tithe? The Christians. Because Muslim population is only 4 million out of the 66 million in the UK. Sasa pesa yako ndio inaenda kufanya hivyo. Si afadhali tufanye hii kanisa yetu ikuwe vile bishop amedeclare tonight. Because we were created and our children were created so that we can be for signs, wonders and miracles. Hallelujah. So that God will help us to conquer the gates of our enemies. And we be positioned. This church is strategic. It's at the gate of this place. Hallelujah. So it is time. Tell somebody it is time. We must put the devil where he belongs. And we must defeat him. And it will start when we are fired up. Hallelujah. The church is destined for victory. Because greater is he that is on the inside of us than he that is out there in the world. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I said last night, you don't know what you have until you begin to bring out the things that God has deposited in you. Is this, I had a testimony from our Nigerian now, our church. This guy, who is a Christian, he was captured by some occultist, and they wanted to take some parts of his body to go and sacrifice. And they surrounded him, and they began to make some enchantment. And the man was worried because all of them have knives, and the man is about to die. And the man began to ask, "Oh God, is this how a believer dies? Oh, okay. Even the mtu amekusa and a dead. This is the way I served you, to die like this." And the Holy Spirit said, "I have put something in you. I put the Holy Spirit. I baptized you with the power of the Holy Ghost. The tongues in you are dangerous." And the man is still worried. And the Holy Spirit told him, "Speak in tongues." And the boy started speaking in tongues. Shut up. You know, he's still fearful. He doesn't know whether it will work, because there are 10 against 1. Shaka. Shaka. Shababa. And the testimony goes that when the man started doing that, smoke started coming out of his nose. Smoke started coming out of his ears. And the man went one step backward. And then he saw, yeah, it's working. Now he went aggressively. And the men went further. They say that they saw fire come out of the mouth, fire come out of the ears. Hallelujah. You don't know what you have. Now you're looking at me. Hey. Fire was coming out of his mouth. Something. Tell somebody you carry something unique. Tell them again you carry something unique. Tell them one more time you carry something unique. If we put the power of God to work, one of you will chase 1,000. Two of us will chase 10,000. Hallelujah. We can be able to resist the enemy in our community, and he will disappear. So that, listen to me, there will be no young men that are being taken by drugs and substance abuse. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I declare it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Young guys with guns, they will come and surrender them in this church.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the church will stand for them and plead amnesty for them with the government. It is possible. Tell somebody it is possible. Hallelujah. Tell somebody again it's possible. The prophet cried, the king cried, "Oh my father, the chariots of fire and the horsemen thereof." And I saw the same when Elijah was going up, and the same thing that happened. But listen, the prophet prophesied something in verse 15. He said, Elijah said unto him, "Take bow and arrows." I want the young man to come here. Do you have people here who are in the world of media and art? You took bow and arrow. Take a bow and arrow. Take a bow and arrow. And you have to be a good actor. You took bow and arrow. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He took what? Kuja hapa wakone vizuri. And what I want to say is that even on his deathbed, there is still some power left in the body of an anointed man and a woman of God. He said, take bow and arrow. And then he tells the prophet, open the window to the east where the enemy is. Tonight we are going to direct our arrows where the enemy is, and we will destroy more enemies than we have done before in the name of Jesus. You know, I want to see whether this young guy can multitask. He's holding bow and arrow and he's opening the window. I don't know how he did that. Glory to God. Because if I were you, and you cannot be able to open the window with a hand, you can kick it with your legs. Hallelujah. God wants the people of God to learn to use unconventional methods. Not just the methods we are used to. Hallelujah. Not yet. Because the prophet, where is your prophet? Put your, and you're coming like a sick prophet. He's holding bow and arrow, but before shooting, let's assume east is that way. I know what you're doing to your pastor, and I don't want you to leave your position here. The prophet put his hands. A good man, and that means that the hand of God, the ability from God, the empowerment from God, the anointing from God, the victory from God coming upon a king that had to fight war with an enemy. Hallelujah. When you go out there for battle, you are not alone. And I want you to know that the battle is not yours. The battle belongs to God. I'm telling you something. The hand of God being upon the king, he will shoot. Hallelujah. And he was told to shoot. I saw the same thing in the story of Gideon. I see some people smiling and laughing. But let me tell you, this is dynamic. There are some people here, God told me, you will shoot the enemies of finances tonight. There are people here who will shoot the enemies of sicknesses and disease. There are people here who will shoot the enemies of marriage issues. There are people here who will shoot and their children will be free. There are people here who will shoot in the air. It looks foolish, but promotion is coming. Yeah. The hand of God. The hand of God. How many of you, sometimes even you, rub shoulders with your bishop? I wish that can happen to me. Tonight, I'll send something in your phone. Because last night, I was blessed. Because you just say favor. Favor. You know what happened? Somebody sent me money from America. And I'll divide the loot with you. Now, he sent my two. Na mimi nikasikia na nikachukua. Na kama mimi nimemba hii church. Kama mimi nimemba hapa. Some of you, that you are passing with your bishop like this. We used to see our men of God. Sometimes you would run away because you don't know whether they have a prophecy from God. We would run away and just think as if we have not seen him. But you don't have to run away because this is a church. You know, those days I was in a ministry where we do hit and run. We come, we do a gospel, we hit the devil, people are saved and we go. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. This is what he's instructing and this is prophetic. Shoot. Open the window and shoot. Open the window and shoot. And he took unto him bow and arrow. And the king said, put thine hands upon the bow. And he put his hands upon the bow. And Elisha put his hands on him. And he said, open the windows eastward. And he opened it. Then Elisha said, shoot. 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 That is what I wanted you to see. Many times we have a prophetic action, but we do it once. We do it once. And we do it like, have you seen the Kali or Maasai? I don't know whether they are Maasai here or Kisi. If it was a Maasai or a Kisi, they will position themselves and scream. Yeah! Woo! Yeah! Yeah! Because this is not easy kubembeleza. This is warfare. And where there is warfare, I'm not the one that is going to be injured. The enemy, because the hand of God is on me, because God is on my side. If God be on our side, who can be against us? It looks like a joke, isn't it? So you try one. Oh, the angels will carry the arrow. You are the one sending it. Hallelujah. Then he stole now. Put the bow down. Take the arrow. Pastor, you may sit. Thank you. And then he stole. Now strike the ground. Strike the ground. Strike the ground. Strike. One. Two. He did it three times. Three. Akasimamia hapo. Hata ni adui gani anaweza kufa mara tatu. And the prophet was so angry. He said, why didn't you do it five times? Six times? Why did you do it seven times the number of completion? Why didn't you even try eight times the number of new beginning? He was angry. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Tell somebody, I'll do it more and more and more. Tell somebody, I'll do it more and more. Hallelujah. Elisha transferred something as he told the king to open the window to the east. He's transferred something. Transferred something. Touching the person. Transferred something. And some of you, I want you to remember the miracles of faith that happened in the Bible. The woman with the issue of blood did not need a man to lay hands on her. She said, if I can just but touch. Some of you, you need to have that crazy faith. Me, I'm a man of faith. I can believe God for anything. I can believe God. When my mother prayed for me, I used to pray for television that had died 10 years. I would lay hands. Chaka basaka. They would plant them. They would talk. Hallelujah. A Aggressive faith. Tell somebody aggressive faith. One time we were doing a crusade in Gong, and I saw a woman who had a goiter. Big goiter. And she had the faith that I'm talking about. We had just finished the crusade and were driving away. But the woman beat the security team. And she cornered us. And she came next to the man of God and pulled her hair. She cut her hair. And I saw the goiter disappear as she touched the hair. We are living in a days where in the churches we are hearing motivational preaching. That is going to end. We are going to be that Holy Ghost church that the bishop is talking about. We want to have inspirational messages. We don't want this key and that key. We want messages that will release the power. The power is not in the keys. Hallelujah. The power is not in a motivational message. It is in the inspirational message. Hallelujah. We saw a tumor going. We went to Morana and were preaching in the crusade. And during the crusade, all of a sudden, and the preaching is not gone, cripples in the crusade ground started rising up. And the people ran to the platform and they beat the platform. And we had to go for our man of God. Pull her and rush her in the car and drive the car out. I'm prophesying in the name of Jesus. That before Jesus comes back, signs and wonders and miracles will begin to flow in this house. As the cripples walk through that door, they will rise up and begin to praise the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. People that are deaf with deaf ears, they will walk and the deaf ears will be opened, because ears were meant to hear, eyes were meant to see, legs were meant to walk. Somebody shout hallelujah. We want the miracles, but genuine miracles. Are you tired? Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Imagine Elijah is there and you are crying for him. Cry for him. Cry for him. Double portion anointing. Elijah is lying down and the king has also come. He has knelt down. He is crying on his face. He said, "My father, my father." Do it. This is the same double portion anointing. It looks like a celebration, isn't it? But there's something happening. Because in obedience, something happens. You see, as you learn to obey the Holy Ghost, He gives you the key. And when you touch microphone on this platform, as you sing those prophetic songs, the sick that we are talking about, they will begin to receive healing. Women with the tumors in our church, tumors will begin to disappear because an anointed man is holding the microphone. This is not a commercial singer who came because she wants to be given an offering after she has praised God. But this is a servant that is called to do a ministry. Hallelujah. And you see, brother, the whole town, this town, young guys like you, they walk in church. Because you came to church. And it's okay sometimes, even if you buy jeans that I have, Bishop Atakupatia permission to sing, because you'll be attracting a certain congregation. And when they come in the house of
estaba el Kikubwa, naweka huko nyuma. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. We are here just fathers, but you, your generation must know God.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You have what it takes. Tell somebody you have what it takes.
This
is the same Elisha. This same Elisha who has transferred the power to the prophet down there. He's the same prophet who came and told the Shunammite woman, because of the prophet's room, that you shall have a son next year. Hallelujah. How many people are believing God for a miracle child? Next year. Miracle child. Must heal the sick. And I know why I'm saying that. We must heal the sick. We must heal the sick. Because one miracle, this church will have no space. One miracle. We with Pastor Carol, we were struggling in the Kawangori. This lady. And she just took the church outside to do an evangelism, what Bishop was declaring. And we met one guy who was mentally unstable. A young guy. He gave his life to Jesus. And when he came to church, he was just looking at this beautiful pastor. He did not want any other leader to minister to him. Pastor. Probably thought he was single. But let me tell you, when that miracle happened, the place where the church was struggling, there was breakthrough. People began to walk into the church. People who were not born again. That shall be the hallmark for this ministry in Jesus' name. Amen. Signs and wonders, I say, shall be the hallmark for this ministry. The church today must heal the sick. The church today must cast the devil. It's about time we put the power of God to work. Elisha put his hands on the king. Now, when you receive the supernatural, you must use it and use it positively. The anointing is never for you. The anointing is never for us. Pastors, when we are ministering. Because this man is anointed. The power of the Holy Ghost is upon him. But he's on a dead bed. He can't heal himself. But many years when he died and he was buried and another feather was brought in his grave, his bones revived a dead man. When you touch people, let something be imparted. Paul would always say, I long to come to the people of Zimmerman because I long to impart something from my hands. Not to take away from them. And listen, I didn't come here to take away from you. I came here to impart something. And I pray that you receive something this week. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. The spirit that raised Jesus, that spirit resides in you. Tell somebody that spirit resides in you. It is time to take bow and arrows. And I want everybody to stand up. Nataka ikimbo ni yoke. Where is the owner of this kimbo? Ikimbo. He parted in a beat is a wall. Because some of you, as you should, some of you are sickly in your bodies. And that sickness is going to leave your body. Amen. Hallelujah. Some of you, somebody here, they refuse with your promotion. This is the second year. And I declare, before the end of this year, you will receive your letter of promotion. Shall transfer him or demote him. Hallelujah. And I want that beat. I want that beat. In an aggressive beat. Because this last 10 minutes, I want us to open our window. If your enemy is in the northern side, you will turn north. And this is a prophetic action. And this being the last day of this conference, as you come here tomorrow to be anointed, some of you will come with the testimonies. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Are we ready?
Yes.
Are we ready?
Yes.
Come on, somebody begin. You're not going to shoot like that. is in this church today. After all, this is a deliverance church. This is not an Anglican church. This is not a Methodist. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody.
Come on.
I say your destiny must pursue you. In the name of Jesus. Hey,
I'm sure.